There are different kinds of maps that you can create in Datawrapper. Choropleth maps, symbol maps, arrow maps, spike maps, and locator maps. In this video, I'll show you how to create our most popular map type, a choropleth map. Hi, it's Guillermina here from Datawrapper, the database tool that helps you create better visualizations regardless of your coding or design skills. Let's get started. Choropleth maps are a very good choice every time you want to show which region has a higher or lower value. Your readers will find it easy to see geographical patterns in them. For this tutorial, we'll visualize what share of the population has access to the internet in most countries of the world. The data come from the World Bank. In the first column, we have the country names. In the second column, the country codes, and in the last column, the value for the share of the population with access to the internet. Let's visualize it. Once you're logged into your Datawrapper dashboard, head over to Create New and select Map. The first question that Datawrapper will ask you is, what kind of map do you want to create? You'll select Choropleth Map. You will then land on the first step, select your map. Here, you'll be able to choose from a collection of over 4,000 base maps with different administrative boundaries. Because we have data for different countries in the world, we'll select a world map. Click on Proceed, and you'll then land on the following step to add your data. There are different ways to import your data into Datawrapper. You can upload a CSV file or an Excel file. You can copy and paste your data into the text field, you can connect to a Google Sheet, or link to an external dataset. For this tutorial, we'll copy the data from Google Sheets and paste it into the text field. In case you just want to try out our tool but don't have the data yet, you can also fill the table with random data. Let's click on this arrow to proceed. As you can see, Datawrapper has correctly matched the country codes in the dataset with each country and has already pre-populated a preview of the choropleth map with the corresponding values. Clicking on Check will take you to the Check tab. It has a warning sign on it. This is because 6 entries for this map are not in use. You can click on End of the table to check these entries. The entries are empty because the World Bank didn't actually have data for these countries, so we'll leave them as is. Let's click on Proceed to go to refine our map. Once you land on the Visualize step on the right side of the screen, you'll always see a preview of the map that will automatically update as you customize it using all the different options on the left side of the screen. You'll see 3 tabs. Refine, Annotate, and Layout. In the first tab, Refine, you can customize your map with all the options on the left side. First, you might want other colors. You can choose the color palette and then make further adjustments to it, like increasing the contrast, by clicking on the button with the pencil. Let's make it easier for readers to know what the data is about. Scroll down to the legend section and change the format of the numbers in the legend to percentage, since the data reflect percentage of population. And then add a title. If you enable the highlighting on hover and hover over the legend, the country that has that value we are hovering over will be highlighted. On the other hand, if you hover over any of the countries, you'll see an arrow in the legend pointing to the value the country you're hovering over has. This is by far one of my favorite features to enable in choropleth maps. Let's also make the map zoomable so that readers can zoom in and out to explore some small countries even further. If you click on Proceed, you'll then move on to the next tab, Annotate. Here, you can add more information to the chart to guide your readers through the story that you want to tell. You can add a title, a description, and notes that will be displayed above or below the chart. You probably noticed how while you hover over some countries, these little text boxes appear. These are tooltips. Tooltips help us give readers more information about what they are hovering over. In this case, we can give more information about the different countries by customizing them. If you click on Customize Tooltip, a panel will appear. You can add data from all the columns you imported in step 2 by clicking on these tokens. Let's customize the tooltips of this map so that they read, in Argentina, for example, some percentage of the population has access to the internet. If you hover over a country, you'll see that the number doesn't come with a percentage yet. Let's fix that by deleting the token and re-add it with the correct formatting. But maybe there are certain countries or data points you want to draw attention to. For that, you can insert annotations. To do so, you can click on Add Text Annotation and place it by clicking on the spot where you want the text to show on the map. If you click on Proceed, you'll get to the Layout tab. Here, you can enable the dark mode option so that if you embed your map on a website, it will automatically switch to dark mode for better readability. You can also add social media buttons to the map as well. The last step is the publish and embed step. Up to this point, the visualization you created is private. That means that only you, only the person who created it, has access to it. There are two ways to get the map out of Datawrapper and into publication. The best way is to click on Publish Now. Right after, Datawrapper will share with you a link to the visualization so that you can share it with others, and an interactive embed code so that you can embed the map on a website. You can also download the map as an image for use in social media or presentations, for example, or as part of Datawrapper paid plans as an SVG or PDF vector files to use in printed publications. And that's it! Congratulations! You just created, customized, and published your first Choropleth map in Datawrapper. I hope you found this video helpful and that you're excited to keep creating more Choropleth maps in Datawrapper. Thanks for watching and happy mapping!